obviously I'm a very good student, and I've been to the gone for big part of the country I've never heard of. I want to stay in Thailand, the capital of, the second city is after I just started graduate. I want to go to the university there, I don't want to go to Vietnam. And it's all sort of traveling, you know, you prepare new opportunities for other, the more European than, you know, the southern part of the country, so I'll be over there. So I went there, and I stayed. And I said my studies lesson, I decided that once I finished all the time to Ghana, like many people come to Europe, faith has a, you know, very strange way of changing your life course. During my studies I met my future wife. And although she said at that time, well, we'll go back to Ghana, you know, when we finish. I think the last year she got pregnant. Not by accident, she got pregnant by accident. And we said, okay, we'll stay a couple of years in Slovenia. And then when the child goes, you know, 2 or 3 years, we'll go back to Ghana. My father was encouraging me to come back. He said, I'm telling you, if you want to stay for her. 1991, as you know, Gustavo broke up. The country of Gustavo and the city. Slovenia went its way politically, racially, Bosnia, Herzegovina, Serbia. And I started working there. And something I noticed, the people there, I didn't know. I wasn't a foreign any longer. I wasn't a black man. I was just a local doctor. I had started to integrate. That integration started not as a plan, not something that I planned, but it started in a very different way. It started in a way in which I related to certain values where I live. And I think that for everything immigrant, my to do that. We all have values in common. And when you start talking about the positive values, the differences are there. Sit in this room, I think there's sit back to it and tell you that. We're different. And it's so obvious. We can't. But a certain values we all hold in common. And when we start talking about those values, religion, be it Christian or Islam, but what's the difference? There's absolutely no difference. Because we believe in something. We believe in some other force. We believe in something higher. And that's it. Common. How we attain that higher value is purely. And that is my way of thinking about integration. We have to talk about the values that make us one. You know, when I was preparing for this meeting, I went on the internet and took up read all about migration, integration, and all the policies that have been done over the last year. And something was lacking. For me, something fundamentally wrong with all, everything that has been written about integration and migration and acceptance. Forces are the same. Everyone talks about targeting forces. People forget about human rights. Because human rights is a fundamental thing. You can talk about forces, you can talk about brain mind here and there. The key, the central part of every integration policy must be human rights. Because human rights doesn't matter whether you're in Europe or in Africa or in Asia. Human rights is fundamental. And that's why I call upon you in our discussion today that you make human rights your central part of your cause. Because if you make some human rights, it doesn't matter where from. And I think the gentleman who said he was from Britain, but And he felt like a foreigner in Luxembourg. To the point, his human rights has been trod upon. My view, of course, is that during our discussion, I know it would take a lot of time. As I said, I had prepared something to read for about 15 minutes, but then I decided I wouldn't read it. I've listened to all the talks in the morning, and all the statistics, which are very, very valid. I prefer that we discuss, you ask me questions, possibly my feelings. I come from a very small part of the region, 17,000 people. The threat of the coast is sandwiched between Croatia and Italy on one side. So it's a very multi ethnic part. We speak Italian, I speak Italian, I speak Slovenian, I speak Croatian, I speak English now. And in my part of the country, where I was living, I suddenly realized, even when looking at me as a black man or the black person, or the witness man, because there are only three or four of us, instead of around 17,000 people. And even if it was a pride for the world that I became the mayor of that part of the world, my citizens were going to surprise me. And when they tell me, we are the Obama of Europe. I love I'm very flattered, you know. But I'm not Obama. My experience as a black person is very, very, very much different from the experience of the world. Thank you.